Brad is asking if it's true that if we take white wine and we pour it onto the red wine stain that might have happened on a carpet, is it true that it will remove it? Brilliant question, by the way, because we do get that from time to time. In fact, there's another version of that question that we also get, and that is, can I use some salt on that stain? So, salt and wine stains. Let's do that, and then I'm going to go to Brad's wine idea. Salt on a stain has come around because people think, oh, you know what, it would absorb the wine, and then I can wipe the salt up, or when it's dry, I can vacuum it up. And unfortunately, that's old wives' tales. So, here's what happens. If you go and buy a little box of color dye that you would maybe dye your jeans with in the washing machine, or if you dye a shirt, a Dylon in particular, what's the one item you will add to the washing machine when you use a dye? You've guessed it. It is salt, and a lot of it. And it's because the salt will set the stain. So, if you are going to put some salt on the wine stain that's on your carpet, you will probably find that even us won't remove it. So, I would advise do not put the salt on the wine stain, but Brad is up the right street. So, Brad said, can I add the white wine and will it really deal with the problem of the red wine stain? Absolutely, Brad, but do yourself a favor. Save the wine, get it in the fridge. What you'd rather want to do, go and get yourself some vinegar, white vinegar. And it's important to be white because otherwise, malt vinegar that's not distilled has got the brown color to it, so it can mark a light colored carpet. Nice distilled white vinegar. And what you want to do is you want to get yourself a cup, you want to get yourself some water, and you want to mix about a 50-50 mixture of the vinegar and the water. And then what you want to do is you now have that mixture. And if we imagine there's a stain on this carpet, which I could probably have created, you want to dab some of that onto the stain. Then you want to use a white cotton towel, nice and clean, nice and absorbent. And you want to use that and you want to then dab the stain. And basically, what it would do is it would dilute that wine down. And it would absorb it into your towel. And the acidicness of that vinegar solution, as is the acidicness of the white wine, will deal with that red wine stain. I have seen very few people being really successful at this. The thing is, you don't do it every day. So we would be dealing with it every day, and we actually have a special acidic product that comes to deal with that and actually hide the wine stain. We would be more successful, but if you're careful and you do this, you may be lucky if it's only a small stain. Now, of course, as you can see there, I've now wet this out and there's a big old patch. So what would you do? You can now go ahead, use a cotton towel like I have here, and what you want to do is lay that dry cotton towel on there once you've absorbed all that, and you want to lay something heavy on top. Like a book or something like that. But what you want to do, if your towel is not as thick as mine and you have a worry that that moisture might seep through, lay yourself a plastic sheet down. Go and get your black bin liner, tear that off, lay it over that, and then lay your book down. Lay it there till the following day and then lift that, and you should see that moisture seeped into the towel. And if there's any wine, it would now sit in the towel rather than in the carpet. So that would help greatly. If that fails, then best to give us a call so that we come and read that for you. But to recap on Brad's question, save the white wine for the following night. Don't waste it. Get yourself some water, distilled white vinegar, and use that acidicness in the water with a 50-50 mix and put it on there and absorb it with a cotton towel. So, Brad, thanks so much for that question.